Welcome back to our show. You know, in the spirit of International Women's Day,
yes,
we want to talk about, you know, a few women that we love and
yes,
admire. I love this. I always love this particular full circle because we get to show love to other people and lift them up. And Trina, you gonna kick us off?
I'm gonna kick you guys off.
Yeah, kick us off.
With Katherine Johnson.
Yes.
Yes, we recently lost her, but her memory and her legacy lives on. Mm. She was literally a human calculator.
Yes.
Literally, before there were computers, she was computing.
Mm.
She graduated high school at only 14 years old.
Wow.
She went on to be one of the first African-American women to go to an integrated graduate school.
Yes.
And she helped the whole orbital mechanics of, you know, the first space flight and subsequent ones. And she also, people didn't know this about her, she was also setting forth doing missions to Mars.
Wow.
People didn't even know that about. And see, coming from Maryland, you know, we have our space center, you know, so, you know, I grew up, you know, learning about Katherine Johnson, but a lot of people didn't really know until her depiction on Hidden Figures.
Yeah.
And there was more than just she and Dorothy and I forgot the name of the other young lady, Dorothy Vaughn and the other young lady, but we were such pioneers in the mathematical world that we rarely get noticed. So I'm gonna take this time out to notice, recognize, and pay homage to Katherine Johnson.
Yes.
That's beautiful. Good. That's beautiful. Well, we have another hero in Beatrice Dixon, who is the creator of Honey Pot.
Ooh.
And we've been talking about Honey Pot over the last few weeks after her commercial that Target put together, just honoring black women business owners. And some women took offense to her saying, hey, I dreamed this big so that other girls who look like me, other black girls, can know if they have an idea, then they too can achieve what I have achieved. And some people took offense to that. We don't know why, but the African-American army of women and some of our allies said, no, not today.
Not today.
And increased her sales by over 50% in one day. I had the opportunity to be with her. Absolutely, let's clap for that.
Yeah.
Had the opportunity to be with her over the weekend at the Essence Wellness House. This woman is absolutely phenomenal, and she keeps it so cool. Y'all gonna see Wednesday when she comes here. She's so cool with
it.
Like, my God, she is unbothered by anything negative, positive. She just rolls, and she is exactly who she is. She is a Beatrice Dixon, and you'll understand why Honey Pot is what it is. She got the idea from an ancestor in a dream that told her what to do. After facing bacterial vaginosis for 18 months, the ancestor came to her in a dream. This is the recipe down to the T.
What?
And she created the recipe for Honey Pot, and here we are today.
That's
real
deep.
Honey
Pot.
Yes.
I'm going to the bag.
Right.
I'm going straight
now.
To Target.
That's right. If it's on the racks.
Right. Yeah.
If not,
she said wait a few weeks because she has to get her inventory. Go ahead, Miss Quad.
She has to get the inventory. Won't God bless you? Yes,
won't
he will. And won't he use you?
Won't he do it?
He will, because he used the people and what they thought was bad turned out to be good for her.
Mm-hmm.
I just love it. But this is also a great story, and we know her as this a huge media mogul talk show host, and we know her as owning Harpo Studios. But we also, I think a lot of people don't know how she actually came into her fortune. And fortunately, I was able to open for Oprah as she came here to Atlanta on her Your Life in Focus tour.
Mm-hmm.
So it was so much fun, so great. And she told the story, and she talked about, you know, her taking a chance on herself and truly believing in herself when she came across and when they pitched her for the talk show. And she said, I don't know if they didn't know what was going to happen, but I'm happy I believed in me.
How about it?
The first year, she forfeited her entire salary, guys. She forfeited, made absolutely nothing just to come back on the back end and negotiate a higher percentage of ownership. Of ownership. And as it continued, and they didn't know that she was gonna, I think it was either Phil Donahue or,
who's the other person right at that time?
It could have been Sally Jesse, but don't. I think it was Sally Jesse Raphael, and she the ratings went through the roof. And at that point, she took on ownership of her own talk show, Oprah. And in the subsequent years afterwards, the percentage began to get larger and larger and larger and larger until she owned the whole entire thing.
Exactly.
And so just that. that's a phenomenal story when it comes down to
she told the story.
And so it was so great. But that's just a great story of believing in yourself and not, you know, stopping at what someone is offering you, but knowing your worth and knowing what you can do with your talents and your abilities. So shouts out to Oprah.
Yes.
Big O in
shots
the building. I love
TSU.
It. You. Yes.
Yes.
Well, ladies, I'm going to keep that same energy as Miss Quad and stick to talk shows.
Yeah.
I'm honoring the Sisters of Sister
Lena.
I think that, and I can honor them because I'm up close and personal and I'm first hand with these amazing ladies of Sister Circle that come to work every single day despite the differences that they're going through in their personal lives. They push through and they come through with good hearts and minds and intentions for the people, for our fans, for our viewership, and to be four African-American women at a disadvantage already, you know what I'm saying? But come here every day and be the spokesperson for all of women, not just African-American women, but be a spokesperson for all women is a big responsibility, and you guys take it on gracefully, myself as well, including all of us, but you guys take it on gracefully, no matter what is said about you on your social medias, no matter what you go through on a day-to-day basis, the mothering, everything that we go through, we come here, we show up, we show out, and we do it for the people. So I'm honoring us today.
Wait, Lena!
Because we are history.
Yes.
We are history, and we will forever be history no matter what.
Yes, wow. Thank you so much, Lena.
You're welcome.
That's how you bring that thing on in. If you'd like to honor somebody, just hit us up on our social media, at Sister Circle TV. We'll be right back.
Yeah.
Somebody got to give us our flowers.
Right now.